Hi, this is Ty Hyderally. I'm a lawyer with offices in New Jersey and New York who concentrates in employment law. In our prior videos, we talked about the implications of Article Executive Order 107 and its implications with regard to businesses that were essential. And then we had another video that talked about the implications of Executive Order 107 on businesses that were non-essential. Now I'd like to talk to you about the implications of Article 107 with regard to businesses that were deemed neither essential or non-essential. So they fall into this kind of middle category. And those include such industries as law firms, courthouses, and certain warehouses, restaurants. So what happens if you're in that situation where you're employed there at a business that is deemed neither essential or non-essential? Well, in this situation, certainly the employer can require employees to work, but there's a mandate that employers have to try to allow employees to telecommute or work remotely to the fullest extent possible. If there are positions within those industries where the employee cannot work remotely, then the employer is allowed to mandate that employee to come into work, but once again has to decrease their footprint in the office as much as is possible, and certainly take actions to protect that employee as much as possible as well. But with regard to, for example, attorneys or other individuals who can work remotely, the employer has a significant obligation to allow those employees to work remotely. If you are in a situation where you're in one of these industries and really there is a significant possibility if you're working remotely and your employer is requiring you to come into work, you really may want to consult with an employment lawyer. Certainly you can come consult with us or any other employment lawyer in New Jersey or New York to talk about what your rights are in that situation, because there are a couple of statutes that would kick in to protect you, such as the Conscientious Employee Protection Act, which is a whistleblower statute, which offers you significant protections depending on the fact situation. Additionally, if you fall sick or need to take sick leave, there are other statutes in New Jersey that apply that protect you, like the Earned Sick Leave Statute. There's the Law Against Discrimination, which protects people who suffer from medical conditions or disabilities that you can look into. So if you need further guidance on these issues, certainly you're welcome to, as I said earlier, call us or any other law firm in New Jersey. I'm Ty Hyderally at Hyderally & Associates, 973-509-8500. Our website is www.employmentlit.com. Thanks. Take care and be safe.